دیش ہندو دیش ہے،
پھر ان کو الگ بھو بھاگ دے دیا گیا، بنگلہ دیش یا پاکستان جائیں، یہاں کیا کام ہے ان کا؟
The Muslims cannot find or rent a house or a flat in any metropolitan city. Is this tolerance we're talking about?
India is home to around 200 million Muslims, but they make up just 14% of the population. And so rising Hindu nationalism has left Muslims feeling increasingly like outsiders. And here are a few reasons why.
بیف کے میٹ کے کھائے بنا زندہ نہیں رہ سکتے تو اس دیش میں نہیں ملے گا، آپ پاکستان میں جائیے.
Hindu nationalists have turned the cow into the country's most polarizing animal. Hindus consider cows sacred, Muslims don't, and traditionally eat beef. In the last 10 years, 76% of all hate crimes in the country have taken place against Muslims. 90% of those are in the last 5 years, and many of them have to do with beef. Cow slaughter has been banned from most of India, but some politicians and far-right groups have gone further by emboldening cow protection mobs to attack Muslims and Dalits on the mere suspicion of eating beef.
Gau maa ki raksha ke liye pran hum de bhi sakte hain, gau maa ki raksha ke liye hum pran le bhi sakte
hain. Agar maata na maante ho, uski hatya karte ho, maine vaada kiya tha, aise logo ke haath pair tod dunga.
Lured, converted, and packed off to Syria.
کیا مسلمان جان بوجھ کر اپنی آبادی بڑھا رہے ہیں؟ بھارت کو 2027 تک اسلامک دیش بنانے کی کیا یہ مسلمانوں کی چال ہے؟
This country has to ensure that the present population ratio is maintained and it doesn't get distorted by things like love jihad.
Love jihad is a term that's been increasingly peddled by Indian leaders in media. It alleges that Muslim men lure Hindu women into marriage so they can convert them to Islam as part of a Muslim holy war against Hindus. The term's been around since 2009, after 18-year-old Silja Raj eloped with her Muslim boyfriend. Her father claimed she was brainwashed and seduced. The Karnataka High Court found these allegations baseless. But in recent years, interfaith marriages have been met with scrutiny. The Hindu right has used false information to promote this narrative.
اس دیش کے لیے درواگیہ ہے، لب جہاد کے نام پر اس بھارت برسا اسلامیکرن کرنے کا ایک سوچا سمجھا شڈینتر ہے.
فار رائٹ گروپس ہیو ایون پبلشڈ ہیٹ لسٹس آف مسلمز دیٹ ہیو میریڈ ہندوز اینڈ لب جہاد الیگیشنز ہیو لیڈ ٹو اٹیکس.
جب ہم اسے کوئی گفٹ دیتے تھے تو وہاں گفٹ کس روپ میں ہوتا تھا؟ یا تو آگرہ کا تاج محل ہوتا تھا، یا پھر کوئی ایسی مینار ہوتی تھی جس کے ساتھ یہاں کی سنسکرتی کوئی میل نہیں کھاتی ہے.
Islam first came to India in the 7th century and has a long rich history, including some of the country's most popular archaeological sites. But is that history now being undermined? Recently, the Taj Mahal, built by the Emperor Shah Jahan in the 17th century and one of the 7 wonders of the world, as well as India's most iconic monuments, has come under fire. It's even been removed from recent official state tourism brochures and replaced with Hindu sites. Foreign dignitaries visiting India who used to receive gift replicas of the Taj Mahal now receive Hindu holy books. But that's not all.
First Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh and now Mughal history has disappeared from Maharashtra state board textbooks.
And there's also name changes. The city of Allahabad has been changed to Prayagraj, and an iconic railway station named Mughal Sarai was renamed after BJP icon Dindayal Upadhyaya. The National Citizenship Registry is a register of names of genuine Indian citizens. The register was used in the state of Assam to identify illegal Bangladeshi immigrants in 2018. 4 million people, almost all Muslim, couldn't prove they were living in India before 1971 and were stripped of their citizenship. But recently, the president of the ruling BJP party said he wished to extend it to all of India.
We will ensure implementation of NRC in the entire country. We will remove every single infiltrator from the country except Buddha, Hindus and Sikhs.
While the move is just rhetoric, it raises doubts over the citizenship of India's Muslims. At the same time, the BJP plans to fast-track citizenship for Hindus from other countries. So is India becoming no country for Muslims?